Our radical Democrat opponents are driven by hatred, prejudice, and rage. They want to destroy you, and they want to destroy our country as we know it.
This could very well be America's last stand, but you are in a valley of decision where you must draw a line in the sand and determine which side you're on. Freedom under Trump, a tyranny under Harris, but you must decide.
America. I got some words, so I got the vocabulary, and my pronunciation is perfect.
Do you plan to visit the border?
Not today, but I have before, and I'm sure I will again.
The unthinkable has happened. The United States has collapsed. The political, militaristic, and economic structure that supported one of the most powerful nations on the planet is no more. A blinkered and complacent approach to the ever-shifting geopolitical landscape has resulted in catastrophe. The dollar, hit by hyperinflation and underhand currency tinkering by hostile nations, is now virtually worthless. Cyber attacks have destabilized the very fabric of society.
That laugh, that kind of cackle. She's like one of those people that you watch and they're laughing at their own joke because there's nothing that's even faintly amusing about what she's being asked or what she's talking about. She does this all the time. I don't know whether it's nerves or just outright stupidity, but she seems to answer every tricky question with this sort of crazy, inappropriate laugh.
Riots have broken out on the streets of every major town and city. Breakaway states, including Texas and California, have declared their independence. Citizens are deserting the country in droves, some to the Mexican border, others to the Canadian border. Worse still, major players on the international stage, most notably China and Russia, are circling vulture-like to pick the bones of what remains of a former superpower that was once considered unconquerable.
Americans that survived Hurricane Helene are struggling. They're in desperation where FEMA or the government is sending no aid to those people. But they have the funds to fund wars in Israel, billions, to fund wars in Ukraine, billions, and to fund illegal people that come here as rapists, as murderers. But when it comes to the American people, the American citizens, you don't have any money? Are you kidding me?
As a recent hurricane survivor, as somebody who's been without lights for 6 days, I am pissed off the fact that I can hear Joe Biden say, we need American people to come together to help the recent hurricane survivor.
Kamala Harris comes out and says $750 to people affected by the storm. She doesn't have, who the hell is she? She's the vice president. God knows. Last thing we need is $750 from DEI hire. It's an insult, man. They're digging people out of the rubble at this stage. And where's the window licker in chief? Why isn't he making the announcement? Pete Buttigieg says you can't fly drones over their efforts while they're... People are looking for... They're looking for survivors, dude. You got... Where you been, Pete? You been breastfeeding again? You been MIA, dude.
The former border czar, Kamala Harris, is responsible for this, for these immigrants being in this country. She's funding these people in these wars with your tax dollars. Biden has funded these wars with your tax dollars. Wake up, people. When questioned, Kamala Harris replies always, "Question." The idiosyncrasy can be detected in the manner in which she evades the questions on the economy and on the border.
We have a secure border, in that is a priority for any nation, including ours and our administration.
Her words are paradoxical, as if the American people are just total idiots. The only idiots that's in America are those that still gonna vote for you after so much exposure on you.
So what goes on when you do this? There is a tendency, black females particularly show this, to seize on something they can identify with, to give themselves a false pride. They already have enough to be proud of if they actualize their own potential. But they have not been raised, acculturated, and socialized to think that way. So you have to give them something that has the semblance of respectability that they can identify with. So they identify with Kamala Harris as a successful black woman. But Kamala Harris didn't particularly go to the first class undergrad school. The law school was the same. It wasn't like she busted her ass in all of these jury trials and she did what Johnny Cochran did back in the 60s when he was working at the DA's office and then when he got in private practice. It wasn't like she made these landmark cases, took these civil rights things up and made history with them. It wasn't like that. It's she screwed her way to the top. A paramours who helped her out. Anybody can do that. So you've got this subconscious thing by the black woman saying, I could do that, but on the other hand, I want to ignore that. And I want to say she got there on by grace of her accomplishments.
Joining us now is Jataiga Eady, the founder of Win With Black Women, which organized that call of Harris supporters with 90,000 attendees. Also with me are Angela Rye, co-host of the Native Land Pod podcast and former executive director and general counsel to the Congressional Black Caucus, and Alexis McGill Johnson, president of the Planned Parenthood Federation of America and the Planned Parenthood Action Fund. Both Alexis and Angela attended that organizing call, but Jataiga, you organized it. So I'd love to start with you. I mean, first of all, who even knew that 90,000 people could do anything all at the same time on the internet without something crashing? But talk to me about how it came together and what it was like to get the number of RSVPs, just the interest that apparently electrified a real part of the American electorate.
For the last 2.5 years, we have been under siege.
Well, there's just two words. It's Kamala Harris, and it was quite historic to be in unity and in coalition with so many black women and some of our allies that joined that call as well. And that night we had just a powerful moment of unity, unified around one goal, and that was our commitment to seeing and ensuring that Vice President Kamala Harris is the next president of the United States.
No, she has none, but you see, it's something to identify with. A sister got to be vice president of the United States. I'm black and I'm proud. Well, she's not black. She's not being proud of what you got conned. So why don't you just say, I just need to work hard and I will be able to look in the mirror and I don't need a Kamala Harris. I can look at myself and say, I'm that person. I'm that entity. I'm that kind of hero or heroine, see.
After so much exposure as to who you really are, the only people that would vote for you are the ones that's naive and really need their craniums checked. Vote for Harris? Are you serious? It's like they've all had lobotomies. And they're being mentally manipulated. I mean, this is one of the most appalling things that I've ever seen. And particularly black people. I know that there's white liberals that want to vote Democrat, but black people, Democrats, that's the party that enslaved you. It's as if you have Stockholm Syndrome. You really can't use your brain. And you want to attack those that's attempting to liberate your thinking and defend those. You act as defense attorneys for those that has done you wrong over these years. Again, it's like you've all had lobotomies and your brains are unable to function independently. Black people must wake up. You've been beleaguered, right? You've been beleaguered by the Democratic lies far too long.
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit black people.
Israel has a right to defend itself without any question. The president and I take very seriously our commitment to Israel and to the people of Israel, to support them, and in particular, to give Israel what it needs to defend itself.
And as long as I'm a United States Senator, I will do everything in my power to ensure broad and bipartisan support for Israel's security and right to self-defense.
For the people of Gaza, the night played out as many have before under Israeli bombardment. The health ministry announced that 51 people were killed in Khan Yunis, and further north, more attacks on a school and orphanage where displaced people were sheltering. This is a special report filmed overnight in two neighborhoods with one hospital in Gaza City by our colleagues in Gaza. And I should warn you, there are distressing images from the start. It's just past 1:30 a.m. Paramedics are on the move again through Gaza City. Another emergency, another Israeli strike, this time at an orphanage where dozens of displaced families had been sheltering. Wait, wait, they tell the rescuers. Don't leave yet, there are more injured. Six people were killed. Survivors say there was no warning, no siren, no protection.
Israel has a right to defend itself.
We started getting all the bodies out. There were a lot of them. None are targets. All of them are children, women and children.
Israel has a right to defend itself.
Before this woman's body can be stretched out, a lengthy debate. How best to cover her up, to protect her dignity in death? As the injured left for hospital. Those already there were reporting to relatives on the other end of the phone who in their families lived and who died.
Israel has a right to defend itself.
Inside, the Jundeya family is in shock.
We were sleeping. We did manage to get our children out from under the rubble.
Her son, Hassan, is six. Her youngest boy, Yusuf, just five.
Yusuf? Yusuf?
He can't answer his uncle back or open his eyes. There are not enough beds for these children, not enough doctors to treat them.
My hands are torn from digging for my children. I don't know where the rest of my children are.
As Mohammed hovers over his seven-year-old girl, Dina, suddenly his son is brought in. It's Hassan. A short time ago, President Biden declared America's full solidarity and support for Israel and discussed the rollout of new sanctions against Iran during a phone call with G7 leaders.
But in an increasingly unstable world, how likely is the collapse of the United States? Surprisingly, it might not be as far-fetched as many people would assume.
Our radical Democrat opponents are driven by hatred, prejudice, and rage. They want to destroy you, and they want to destroy our country as we know it.
The dollar is no longer the most important currency in the world. Its default status is being challenged by the euro and crypto alternatives. According to the U.S. Treasury, the national deficit was a whopping $828 billion up to October 2023. The Council on Foreign Relations estimates that the U.S. has sent $75 billion in aid to Ukraine following the Russian invasion of 2022. Two unsustainable and potentially devastating statistics in their own right.
16 out of the past 20 years, Americans have been miserable. Vote Kamala Harris if you're an idiot and you want to make America miserable again. Vote Kamala Harris if you want to remain miserable and you're an idiot and you want to make America miserable again. Vote Trump if you want to make America great again. I'm Cahan Tugger, Doc, and I approve this message.
Only collusion was committed by the Democrats, the fake news media, and their operatives and the people who funded the phony dossier, crooked Hillary Clinton and the DNC.
No, go.
I'm not thinking, Mr.
That's
President.
That's okay. I know you're not thinking. You never do.
I'm sorry?
No, go ahead.
But he...
No, excuse me. He didn't say a lot. He said we did a phenomenal job. He didn't say a lot. He didn't say you did a good job on ventilators, but nothing else. No, he said we did a phenomenal job. So report accurately, because you are one of the most inaccurate reporters. And those people have been just absolutely excoriated by some of the fake news, like you, your CNN, your fake news. And let me just tell you, they were excoriated by people like you that don't know any better because you don't have the brains you were born.
Vote for no damn Democrat, vote for somebody just because they black, they color, they skin. But it's the politics and what they represent to me. It's gonna be Trump, thump around. You heard me? That's how I'm coming, because she black. I'm not voting for her.